If you read the ancient literature on rosehip, you will realize that it is the roots, the leaves, the seeds, and the shells. Nowadays, the majority of research has focused on the fruits only. It is very important to realize that we need the seeds as well as the shells because they contain very different ingredients. We have the fatty acids, we have the galactolipids, all the vitamins, especially vitamin C. We have a lot of flavonoids. Some flavonoids are mainly in the seeds and some are mainly in the shells, and some flavonoids are in the seeds as well as in the shells. For example, the tillerosites, and they are very essential to losing weight. Tillerosite is very, very predominant in the seeds, but nearly not present in the shells. A lot of research here in Denmark have elucidated that we need the seeds as well as the shells. And one of the main products worldwide is produced on Langeland, Denmark, and it contains half seed and half shell. What does the powders look like? The color can be very, very brownish, and this can be caused by the fact that there's no seed added, and it can also be caused by the fact that the heating procedure has been using a very high temperature. The other powder you see on the picture is more pale. It contains seeds and shells, and the heating procedure have never exceeded 40 degrees. And by not heating too much, you will preserve a lot of active ingredients. GOPO was a galactolipid, which was isolated some 8 or 10 years ago. GOPO acted as a strong anti-inflammatory agent and also as an antioxidant. We went to the shelves in different stores in Europe and we took all the different rosehip powders we could find. And we had a neutral laboratory to do an examination. And we were able to show that the amount of GOPO was very, very different. The Danish powder from Langeland, you can see on the right, it contains a huge amount of GOPO, but you can see the others contain less. And this is according to the heating procedure, and this is also according to what version of a rosehip you use, because there are so many different versions of rosehip. So, when you see a rosehip product, you should read where it comes from and try to find out does it contain seeds as well as shells. It seems as rosehip powder works in osteoarthritis and rheumatoid arthritis and in other inflammatory diseases. We still need to know a lot about the powders. But today we have realized that we need the seeds as well as the shells to have the optimal powder.